Perfect, so let's continue our tour on our booth and we can check out our recently announced STM32L5 product. And Jan will be very happy to tell us a little bit more about this latest device.
Hello. So who are you?
Hello, I'm Jan Pichard from ST Microelectronics. I'm going to present you our new product, the STM32L5, which is our new product from the ultra-low power segment. So
this is an ARM V8M. This is a ARM Cortex-M33, right?
Yes.
This one there?
Yes, this one. So, yes, it brings a new core from ARM, the Trojan core, and running at 110 MHz. This chip brings some innovation for power consumption, but also a full set of security, starting from the core, the Trojan core, but also other peripherals that we are integrating in our platform. With this solution, you can split your application in four domains, secure, non-secure, and you can again split into another domains, privilege, non-privilege. And what is really good with this platform is that you can assign any of your peripherals into one of these four domains.
So is it more security than other solutions before? Is it different kind of security? What's going on?
It's much better flexibility to design your application and to do some isolation. So you can isolate your code, flash, your RAM, and you can assign any peripheral. So at the end, it's full flexibility and more granularity of your system.
So before there was still some isolation possible, right?
Yes.
But now is it built into the architecture or?
It's built in from the hardware, starting from the core, but also from all the peripherals. So we have propagated the Trojan aware functions on all our peripherals, meaning that it's really high flexibility, granularity.
So this chipset, what does it compare with on your previous line in terms of performance?
So it's a plus 20% performance versus our L4 platform.
Versus
L4? And
which is ARM Cortex M4?
M4, right. And so plus 20% performance, better power consumption, and full flexibility in terms of software isolation.
Is it on a smaller nanometer, or is it the same?
The same. So the L5 is based on the same technology like the L4 products, but of course we are already preparing the next step to
because it's ARM Cortex M33. There's some new optimizations in the architecture.
The thing is, we didn't want to make too many changes in the same time, so we took the L4 technology platform. And what we did, the main change was to replace the M4 by the M33.
So is this going to be a big deal to do new types of security in the microcontrollers now? Enable some new things?
Well, yes, of course. Based on this TrustZone and the TrustZone implementation of ST, increasing this to the periphery level, we want to bring more and more security features to our customers.
So you got a price?
Yeah, we have just been received this PSA level 1 certification from ARM. And so this is the first stage, but what we target with this platform is PSA level 2 certification. But it's still under definition, and we are working with ARM to get this platform certified PSA level 2.
What's going to be the level 2?
Level 2, it's more isolation. Level 1 is you split your application in secure, non-secure, and with level 2 you have another isolation. So at the end you can have secure, non-secure, privilege, non-privilege. So it's more isolation.
Is it available?
It's under development, and PSA level 2 certification is under definition. So we're working with ARM to get
this chipset?
This chipset is already available for our alpha customer, and for mass market it will be available by October this year.
And is it the whole embedded world that will use this kind of solution now?
I wouldn't say whole, but of course customers which are really caring and looking after increasing the level of security inside the application will get very much interested by this.
All right. Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Thank you, Alan. Okay, so moving on with the STM32 products, let's take a look on our recently introduced STM32G0, which is the new alternative for entry-level STM32s. It brings bigger flexibility, simplicity, and robustness together with some new peripheries. And one of the new peripheries is periphery dedicated to handle Type-C and power delivery communication. And Luboš will tell us a bit more.
Hi.
So who are you?
My name is Luboš Kudelka, and I'm an amplification engineer from Perak support team. And here I'm introducing the USB Type-C solution from ST.
So how much Type-C does ST do?
So actually, for now, we have mainly two solutions. One is from AMS, so that are the solution like this. One small and compact.
What are we looking at here?
That's ST-USB 4500, and it's the compact solution for USB Type-C sync only. So the purpose is to easily add the Type-C functionality to your current product. But
so it's only data or what?
No, it's only power. We are
only
actually
power.
Not touching the USB data lines. So here in this product, the purpose is that with any other product you may have, you add the option to get the power from universal charger. So then in your home you may have only one charger for all the application. So for example, your radio want 15 volt, you put there 15 volt using Type-C. Your mobile want 9 volt, you provide 9 volt. Your tablet want 20 volt, you provide the 20 volt.
So it's power delivery?
Yes.
And it's a standard that just works?
Yes.
Every device says how much they need and it just gives exactly what
yes,
it needs.
Yes, if it support, they agreed. So this is like the easier solution with the MS. And then we have the USB Type-C now integrated in the STM32G0.
What is it, 3.0 certified?
That's a power delivery certification, also with it's still improved, and with the 3.0, it's current up-to-date certification. We have new features, much more extended stuff. So right now it supports the programmable power supply that you can choose with better granularity what is the voltage provided to your end device to have more optimized charging of the batteries and also less power losses on the cables and end device. There is the option for the authentication and faster swap.
What kind of involvement does ST have in terms of display output with the Type-C?
So we can show you here now on the example that we have here the S9 and the G0 is negotiating with the mobile phone to send the video data through the Type-C cable and then connect to the display port, and you can see it here the same also on the monitor.
So it's a Samsung S9?
Yes.
On the screen right here?
On the,
and it's only ST chips or something else also? ST does everything?
ST does the negotiation and then use the external switch to connect the Type-C cable, the Type-C lines to the display port. Because it's in this board quite universal and it's not connected directly. But we have some other design with STM32F0 where the F0 do the negotiation and it's directly connected to the display port connector.
What kind of challenge is it to do this negotiation? It just works every single time? What's the challenge for a developer to make this work?
Only take the chip and load there our example.
And then has to manage the power for every port or everything?
Also can be, but in this case the power needs to be managed.
All right, cool, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much. So after checking the Type-C, a little bit of security, of course, one point we can miss on our booth is solutions linked to RF.
Yeah.
And we are showcasing a couple of technologies here.
Yeah.
One of them is pretty unique, so this is firmware upgrade over the air using LoRa technology. And my colleague Benjamin will be very happy to tell you more about it.
Hi.
Yeah, sure. So today we're demonstrating our ability to perform firmware upgrade over the air with LoRaWAN protocol. So that means
right here?
Yeah, sure.
So what are these devices right here?
Yeah, so the setup is as follows. On the hardware side, we have an STM32L4 on the Niklo board here, and a Semtech transceiver here, which is an SX1276. Behind that, there is a custom board whose purpose is to show the behavior of a current firmware running on it.
And what is the networking going on here?
So in terms of network, we collaborated with our partner Actility to perform this demonstration,
which is doing is it LoRa or?
Yeah. The firmware upgrade is performed through LoRaWAN. Through LoRaWAN protocol. And in terms of network server and application server, we use ThinkPod, a suite of network services from Actility, enriched with what we call reliable multicast server. Multicast is being the ability to update a subset of our device fleet right here. That means that we can select the amount of device that we want to update.
And a secure update?
It verifies
and just puts it on and...
Yes, right, that's correct, yes.
And if the power is disconnected in the middle of an update, it's still okay, or...?
Yes, exactly, because the new firmware that is being pushed is actually, first of all, a push in the backup area of the flash, and that means that even if there is a kind of power shutdown, the current firmware will still be running when the power will come back.
All right, cool. All right, thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Nice. So if you go around around here.
Yeah, be interested in the microcontroller.
So, thank you, Benjamin. Yeah. So continuing around the corner, we have another technologies more focusing on BLE, FRET, and LTE. Okay, so we are using the STM32WB to demonstrate the multi-technology RF technology protocol solutions.
So it's doing a mesh and LTE. Hello. Hi, so what are you showing here?
Yes, here we are demonstrating the new STM32WB chip. So the chip, the main characteristic of this chip, there are two cores. One core for the wireless, BLE, ZigBee, and also the second core for the M4 is for your application.
So there's a one point, one is the M0 plus,
M0 plus,
and the other one is M4.
Yes, the M4.
And two on one what?
Yes.
Two on one board or one?
Two on one chip.
Chip.
The chip. This one, you can remove the cover, you see the chip, the component, and all the stuff around to make it work. And so, in the future, we will produce a module with this.
There's a chip right there, is a new chip or?
Yes, it's a new chip. It has been officially announced last Monday.
And so what is this market for?
Market is for people who want to port their application and to have only one chip instead of two chips, one for the MCU and one for your wireless. So today's the demo. We use the same board five times and we add shield for sensors. We are in a mesh topology and we use a thread in this area. This device, every 30 seconds, switch to BLE. So we can exchange data in BLE with this board, which is the same. And this board is connected to this board, which is also a new module for the LTE. This chip embed STM32 for your application, ST33 for secure storage, an embedded SIM, an Alter modem, quad SPI memory, regulators on crystal. So you only need to add an antenna, a sensor on the power, and that's it. And after, you also have a local display with power with TouchFX. So in local, you can display the data.
But this is very advanced, right?
Yes, very. And here we use a network simulator, which is provided by Amarisoft, and then the data. Amarisoft company will provide the network simulator, and the data is sent to the cloud. The cloud we use is GrooveStream, our partner.
So who are you?
I'm Mark Laurie. I'm support of the new STM32WB microcontroller.
So what was the consideration when doing this? Mesh is like the kind of like the new important thing in the industry, right?
Yes.
People want to be able to do a smooth mesh, easy mesh.
Yeah.
And this is what the solution is for?
Yes. So in this new microcontroller, we embedded a second core which manage all the radio.
So it's basically a dual core.
It's a dual core. One core for the radio frequency and the other core for the application user.
Does it run two different OS or?
No, there is no OS.
What is a system?
The system is a shared memory which like a mailbox to transfer.
And is this solution being implemented already by some demo right here?
Yes.
You can introduce these guys. Hey. Hi, let me go around. Yeah, right here. Hi. Hey, so who are you?
I'm with Stepanek, so I'm a member of the microcontroller application support team in Prague. And I'm mainly responsible for the STM32WB application support for the EMEA region.
So this is, can I take it off? Can you show?
Yeah,
what is this?
So it's our dongle, so it's an evaluation board with STM32WB inside. It's even certified as a module, so that's why we have the shielding on top of our MCU. And this is just a basic demonstration because everyone knows about Bluetooth mesh, everyone knows about Thread, but many people forget that you have quite nice network capabilities even with the standard Bluetooth low energy stack. So basically our device provides the support for Bluetooth low energy dual role, so you can be a central and peripheral at the same moment. And we support multi-link connection, so that means that you can have to 6 links as a central to 6 further peripherals, and at the same moment you can have up to 2 links as a peripheral to 2 central devices. So you can see it here, so you can implement like a scatternet topology. So you have one device which is connected to 6 peripheral devices. One of these peripheral devices is at the same moment connected or extending the network to this device. So as a central of this device, and this device is fully extending the network to 2 additional peripherals, and here another node is extending the network to 5 further peripherals.
So what is going on here? This is talking to this?
Yeah. So in fact, all are connected in one network. All can communicate with each other, and basically this is the simplest way how to implement some larger networks using the BLE technology.
Can they all update their firmwares and everything?
Yes, you could implement the firmware over the air update for all the nodes. You could distribute it. You could implement some energy consumption balancing. So for example, if this node, because it has a link with 6 peripherals, if the battery would start to deplete a little bit, it would switch the role to another node, which has some higher energy still in its battery, so it could establish the link with the nodes. And
is it complicated to develop for this?
It's very easy. It's STM32, so it's easy. It's using the same ecosystem like our other STM32 devices, so you can use STM32 Cube MX, the HL libraries. We introduced a new simple sequencer in our firmware library to support the complexity of applications which are running some RF stack. So yeah, and it's really easy. I like it.
Cool. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
So this is going to be a big deal, right? The mesh.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the connectivity and the RF connection is becoming very important for many applications. People want to connect their mobile phones into various applications, so this is really key to have an energy-efficient product, allowing customers to quickly and effectively develop and increase the application to a connectivity like BLE.
Nice.
And as you can see behind you, right?
People are queuing here?
Yeah, we are queuing, and the reason they are queuing is because as every year we try to support as many as people as possible, students, makers, geeks, with our boards, because we believe the boards are a good way and good element to practice and evaluate our solutions.
And people are queuing to get over there to your...
Yes, so we have pre-selected a couple of boards people can select from. So they have a possibility to select one out of 5 MCU boards and one NFC board. And maybe we can ask here, Björn, why he's here, why he's really interested in such a board.
Hi, my name is Björn. I'm from Augsburg. I'm studying there at the University of Applied Sciences. We use the ST microelectronics boards for prototyping. We often programmed interfaces. I personally use them for my own hardware as well. I'm currently trying to develop a UAV for my personal purposes. It's a little drone. Yes, exactly. Yes, that's correct.
So, like a drone?
Yes, exactly. It's a very small one.
Like quadcopter?
Yes, in a quadcopter state.
So you think the ST is going to allow to coordinate all the 4 copters?
Definitely. It's a very excellent board to do the prototyping because it's very hard actually to find a suitable board for these purposes. And during university states, I learned the whole platform and the Cube MX platform, and it's actually very, very good to do these kind of projects.
So which board are you going to get here to get to the Cube?
You have chosen already?
Yeah.
Are those the boards available there?
Yes, exactly.
So let's go on the board. So let's stand right next to it. Which one do you want?
Well, I will... Okay. I will probably decide for this one because it's possible to use it with an operating system. It's a very excellent board. In the university, we only use this one. This is also an excellent board, actually, for prototyping. It can, it has interfaces for lots of projects. And the other...
Do you have any experience with this?
Yes, that one as well. It's also low battery operated, lots of interfaces, and it's also excellent for prototyping.
But this is a big one. Can you put this in a drone?
It's really very, very big, of course, because of the prototyping. For that, it's excellent. To put it like this into a drone wouldn't make any sense. But just to test the interfaces, it would be great.
Cool. So once you've done your project, you're going to put the video on the internet?
I hope so.
Okay. Cool. Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you very much. Thank you for your interest and use of our boards. And for giving this interview, I have a special present for you. So this is the MP1 Discovery Kit.
Wow, thank you very much.
Enjoy.
Can
we
see? Yeah, of course. Yes. So this is, which one?
This is the MP1 Discovery Kit, the one we have seen at the beginning of our video. Okay, so you have, well, we have the product inside, right?
Yes. So it's with the dual A7?
Dual A7, 1M4. You see you have the interfaces for the graphics, USBs. You have the Raspberry Pi connector, you have the Ethernet connectivity, and on the bottom we have the Arduino connector, slot for the SD card, because of course you can boot the system from the SD card.
Is it a gigabit?
Yes.
Gigabit Ethernet?
Yes.
So can you put this on a drone, you think?
Probably it's not so recommended to use within the drone, but depending on the data traffic going on between the drone and other hardware, it could be an option.
Do you think you know how to do software for this? Because this has got a whole other layer of more things, right? With the Linux and everything?
Exactly. It's going to be lots of work, but I think there's lots of support on the ST homepage, and also our university professors use these products, so there's lots of development resources and help.
You could potentially use this as your main computer, right?
Yes, definitely. It's
also
strong enough.
Right? Cool.
Yes, absolutely.
Right. Thanks a lot. Well, you can use this to program the other ones too.
As well, yeah.
All right.
That works.
Cool. All right.
Good idea.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Enjoy the show. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Can you walk through there?
Yes, of course. Let's go.
So this is a process where people click and then
so people can select one of the boards, they simply scan their badge, and then our nice hostess provide the board.
Nice. And this is one of those, and you have a bunch of them here.
Yeah, so we have selected a couple of types from the, let's say, more high performance to the low performance as well, low power.
And ST, you're famous for giving out boards at the embedded world, right?
Absolutely.
How long time have you been doing that?
Well, we started since the beginning of STM32 story. So this was back in 2008. Our first discovery kit with STM32 was there from 2010.
At embedded world.
At embedded world, exactly. And since then, really, in average, every year, we are between 8,000 to 10,000 different boards that we distribute here.
Nice. And what happens with all these boards you give out? Do you think people do lots of cool things?
Of course, this is what we are hoping to. We are not able to follow all of them, but by registering for the board, we are also giving them the access, and we inform them with the greatest news, links for new tools, so we try to make them inform for the latex products, solutions to make their job easy.
Nice. And you have a whole bunch more demos around here.
Absolutely. So we are moving a bit to our corner dedicated to automotive products. And here, one of the latest products that we have launched as well recently is a product which is called Stellar.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Here we are.
And Piero will be happy to tell you a few more words about it.
Okay, we can tell you quite very few things because it's a new device. You can see that it's working, operating, because even if the demo is simple, it's showing.
This is ARM Cortex R52.
Yes, this is the very first ARM Cortex R52 that we are doing.
In the world, or that you do?
In the world.
In
because
the world.
We are doing in partnership with ARM.
So this is the most advanced for real time?
Absolutely. So advanced that we cannot disclose too much at the moment. It's still completely secret, or almost secret, only very few partners are already working. You can see here a real partner.
So where's the chip?
Application, the chip is here. This is the star of our Stellar.
Is a big chip.
This is a big chip, but is real big inside. There are 12 cores. running at 400 megahertz, plus three cores for an accelerator of some features, and is the medium. We will have a more performance version.
Is it there?
This is there, yes.
And you will have even a more performance version?
Which
market is this for?
Very high-end, because this will not substitute our SPC5 family that you can see in the gateway, for example, but is going on the top. So addressing very emerging new application.
For example, what could it be?
We can say autonomous driving, high efficiency radar, and any other things you can imagine that can require five different clock domain, 12 cores in lockstep, and very high frequency.
So what's the main difference of the ARM Cortex-R and ARM Cortex-M? Is just real-time component?
The R that is indicating real-time. So is an M53 version. That is been removed the MMU, so it's becoming 52, and it's been introduced the very special architecture real time. So at the end is R52.
And the Cortex R is a big market. A lot of people are using R everywhere.
We hope. We already know some number because we discussed a lot with our customer, but I cannot tell you now.
Cool. All right. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So you're doing lots of things in the automotive.
Yeah. So automotive is of course one of the important market segments for ST. Not only on the microcontroller domain, but the power domain. You know, the e-mobility is becoming more and more important for our planet, for our ecosystem, so we are also investing in this direction.
And what are you showing right here?
So right here we have an application solution, different types of technologies for asset tracking.
Yeah.
Okay.
So hello.
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm Carmen Brigante from System Research and Application, and here we are showing
So the little cow and the mouse, they all have, what are they doing?
This is a smart farm application for animal tracking, with LoRa asset tracking that allow with the GPS capability and LoRa communication to track the animals on the dashboard part of the farm, and also to see the animals on the map. And we have also a complete set of sensors to monitor the status of the animals in terms of temperature, pressure.
So what is the name of the chip?
The chip is a LoRa Transceiver 1032L0 plus the LoRa transceiver and the new module of GPS by ST.
Is it part of this?
Also, we need to
Is it this? It's another demo, right? Yeah? So it's right here with this. Is this part of it?
It's another on cellular connectivity, plus the use of TomTom map, we are able to retrieve the address of the point retrieved by the GNSS chip.
All right. Cool. Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Thank you.
So that was lots of different things around here.
Absolutely. You see, ST is we always try to come to Embedded with a lot of new products, new solutions. We bring a lot of engineers, our experts, which are here on spot to talk to our customers, to answer most of their questions.